I promised to do a part two of this WavY design using Canva and Photopea for this one. And we're going to put it on a t-shirt. Join me. Blank canvas. And then you're going to press T for text, or you're going to press your forward slash so that you access text. I loved this 10 headline font. You could use any font that you want to use for your design. So the company that I'm designing for is Bene. And we're going to duplicate the text for the second line. And we're going to reduce the size of that and align it to the text above. We'll change the color for that one and make it nice red. And we are going to duplicate the last part of our text, services. So this is quite popular with t-shirts, the retro design. So I thought we'd do it together so that play around with the designs, do a couple of designs for your customers or for yourself. The first part is done. So you're going to go to your share and you're going to download your design as a transparent background. If you don't have transparent background on Canva, or if you don't have Canva Pro, you're more than welcome to trial it for 30 days using my link below. Otherwise, you could always download it and go to remove.bg and remove the background. Once you've downloaded your design, you're going to jump in on Photopea. And this is www.photopea.com. You're going to click and you're going to drag your design to the editor itself. And then it'll open a canvas with that layer that we just edited to the design. The next thing, you're going to select edit and you're going to go to transform. And we want the warp design. So you're going to select warp, and you see the editor would add lines on the design to allow you to start putting the warp and the distortion and making the design fun the way that you want. Then you're going to select on none, because these are the different kinds of waves that are available that you could be using. We are going to go with a wave. You're going to select wave, and then the system will add a wave for you. If you are happy with the way that it has designed for you, you are then leave it that way, or you could go to the drop down on the bend. And then you could start tweaking it and aligning it the way that you want. So I was happy with the 50%. The other thing, when you click and you hold, you could bend it and warp it the way that you want. So I'm going to control Z. Cool, that's pretty much it. You're going to go file, export your design as a PNG. And if you want it not to be so distorted, you're welcome to reduce the width so that it's a little bit smaller and it's less distorted. Then you're going to click on save and your design is saved. You're going to jump back to our Canva and we're going to open a new page, or you could delete this other page if you're not going to use it. So it's up to you. We're going to click and we drag our design that we've just downloaded from Photopea. Next, we're going to just take away the extra space on the design itself. And then in order for it to have that courier look, I went on my elements and I searched for fast. I just went in there and I typed fast, and then I got different kinds of fast speed like graphics that I could use. And then I found the one that I was happy with and I edited it. So I'm just gonna go back to the one that I found. I'll show you the name of it so that you have it. It is called Line of Speed Fast Motion. And then you just nicely align it to your design like that. And that's part two done and dusted. All you do now, you're going to download your design so that you could add it to a mockup. You know, when you want to show it to a customer in real life and you want to show them how it might or it's going to look like eventually on a t-shirt, mockups are a wonderful way to do that. So after you've downloaded the design, you could just go to your landing page on Canva and scroll down to mockups. And then you could search for different kinds of mockups. I looked up men's t-shirt and then I scrolled down until I found the mockup that I wanted to use. I found this mockup, and the extra mockups that are available are on Canva Pro. Again, if you want to trial it, go to my link below and then play around it and see. There's a video that I've created that you could find. I'm going to link it above so that you're able to go learn the full process of editing your mockups and making sure that it looks spot on. Once you get here, you just click on select and then you upload your design. So I'm going to click on upload and you're going to find your design and you edit on like that. and then you just click on it once and you say select, and then it starts adjusting and adding it to the mockup itself, and then it looks like that. Once you're happy, you click on save. You could adjust if you want. The next video that you could watch is the full video that I did on how to use mockups on Canva. Thank you so much for joining me on this tutorial. I will see you on the next video.